Hello friends, so in this video we are going to see how you can swap two numbers using arithmetic operation. So I'm going to create a file. I'll name it as a swap.c and I'm going to include some basic things in the C code, that is standard on input output and the main function. I'm going to declare two variables, that is num1 equal to 5 and num2 equal to suppose 30. So what we have to do is we have to call a swap function. So for that I'm just calling a swap function, swap, and I'm going to pass this num1 and num2 by reference, that is the address of num1 and num2 to this swap function. And what we are going to do is we are going to print the values of this num1 and num2 before and after calling this swap function. So before I'm printing, and as we have not defined this swap function, we are going to define this swap function. And here also we have to catch this address in value of operator, that is num1 and num2. And as we are going to do using arithmetic operator, so what we have to do is here, that is we don't have to use the third variable, and because we are doing it using arithmetic operator, so here what we'll do is I will just add num1 and num2 and store that result in num1. So here, as we are passing the address of num1 and num2, we have to use value at operator here. So the final result will be like this. So num1 here will be equal to value of this num1, that is 5, and value of num2, that is 30. So this will be the final result of this statement. So final result of num1 will be equal to 35. And in the second step, what we are going to do is that num2 equal to value at num1 minus value at num2. So in this step, what is going to happen is num2 equal to, so as we have modified the value of num1 here, so value of num1 will be 35, and we have not modified the value of num2 in this function, so the value of num2 will be same. So here we are going to minus 30 and the final value of num2 will be 5. And in the third statement, what we have to do is num1 equal to value of num1 minus value of num2. The same statement we have to repeat, but for that result is stored into num1. So as we have modified value of num1 in the first statement, that value should be taken in this statement, that is num1 equal to 35 minus, and in the second statement you will see that the num2 value is also getting modified. So that thing also we have to consider, and the value of num2 here is 5 as it is getting modified in the second statement. So accordingly, value of num1 is 30. So as you have seen that when we have passed the value of num1 in this function, the value of num1 was 5 and value of num2 was 30, but at the in the function they are getting modified. And you will see that value of num1 here is now 30 and value of num2 here is now 5. So as we are passing it by reference, you will see that result is getting reflected in the main function. So we'll just copy this printf statement and we'll print here, and I'll give it as after swapping. So by compiling and executing this code, you'll get to know that the values are getting swapped or not. So I'll just open it in the integrated terminal and I'll just compile it using GCC and the file name, and I'll press enter, and you will see that a dot out, that is executable file is created, and I'll just execute it using dot slash a dot out and pressing enter. So here you will see before values of num1 and num2 are 5 and 30, and after values of num1 and num2 are 30 and 5. So that way you will know. If you're not understanding this, you can also give here some more information about num1 and num2 in the printf statement, that is num1 equal to whatever value is there and num2 equal to whatever value is there. So I'll just remove this swapping also, so it will get aligned, printf statement will get aligned, and you will get a better perspective of swap function. So after doing any modification in the code, you have to again compile it using GCC, and again we have to run it. So this way you will see that before swapping, that is printf statement before swapping has num1 value of 5, num2 value as 30, and after calling this swap function, this many operations are done in the swap function, and after that the value of num1 is 30 and value of num2 is 5. So in this way, without using any third variable, using arithmetic operation, that is plus and minus operations, we are doing swapping operations. So that's all for this video, and thank you for watching, and please subscribe for more videos.